What's up, everybody? This is Danny, and this is part two of the epic camera comparison between the Google Pixel 9 Pro XL, the iPhone 15 Pro Max, and the Samsung Galaxy S24 Ultra. So we're gonna do this at night, and we're gonna see if the Pixel is reign king this year, or is it gonna be the iPhone or the Galaxy S24 Ultra? So let's test these in low light conditions and see which one comes out on top. Let's do it.
If you didn't catch part one of this camera comparison, then make sure you watch that one after this video, because that's all about the daytime. I did this and separated them because I can get more into depth this way. So let's just go ahead and get started. I've said this before, but more than ever on this comparison, it's going to come down to personal preference, because all three of these cameras behave differently and all have faults, but when they nail shots, they look absolutely amazing. But let me generalize what you're going to notice if you're trying to make a buying decision between these three smartphones. A lot of the times you're going to get a brighter image with the Pixel 9 Pro XL. It tends to expose a stop or more higher even without night mode, but this restaurant is really dark inside and all these cameras did a great job with a 1 second night mode exposure. And while the iPhone was the most accurate, the food captured looks more appetizing on the other two. In this one, the Pixel did an amazing job of capturing so much detail and color, and while it's not accurate, it's impressive. The Galaxy S24 Ultra is the accuracy winner here, and the iPhone looks nice, but I can't ignore this right here. All three of these can produce great looking nighttime photos, but you're going to get weird kinks like this where one misses the white balance like the Pixel 9 Pro XL did, and you will get some variations in pictures without night mode like you see here. They look very similar, but then when you activate night mode, you're going to get some brighter renditions and sharper images, and it does go back and forth. The iPhone had the brightest here. That red tint on the Pixel camera is still visible in nighttime photos too, but depending on the scenario, you might not notice it as much as you do here in this photo. Even with night mode on, you can still see it, but the iPhone likes to run warmer with a yellow tone, where the S24 Ultra tends to stay neutral. There are some very good reasons to love the Pixel 9 Pro series cameras at night, because when it nails the photo, it looks amazing. It's not over sharpened, it has a nice natural depth of field, and the colors can stay more muted, which helps if you don't like oversaturated photos in some scenarios. So Pixel fans will enjoy this camera like they should, but I want to mention a few things that I came across while testing this camera. First is the noise that is present on the nighttime images, especially when it involves the night sky. Now don't get me wrong, this doesn't happen in every picture, and you might not care if you don't really pixel peep, but the noise reduction is better on the Apple and Samsung side of things with photos. Sometimes this is caused by overexposing, like here, you punch in and you can just see how noisy this is, and just adjusting contrast would probably get rid of that. While I do want to reiterate, this doesn't happen all the time, I did see it more often than I would have liked to. So if you are a Pixel 9 or Pixel 9 Pro user, let me know if you're encountering the same problem. I also noticed this on the ultra wide camera. This could be because this is a new lens and they might need to optimize for it. Now, I'm not saying there isn't noise at all on the Apple and Samsung side, it's just way more noticeable on the Pixel when this happens. And it is not a fluke, I can show you some more examples. This is a very dark alleyway, and the Pixel does a great job of capturing more light initially. But here it is with night mode, a standard glow up that you get with most flagship phones, brighter and more detailed, but punch in and you can see again just a noisier shot, so I thought I would point that out. But I guess it's only a problem if you care about it, but since cameras are such a big part of the Pixel's marketing, I am hoping that this will be addressed in a future software update. The second thing I noticed is the light reflections. Yes, all smartphone cameras have light reflections and orbs. It's a natural thing to have when pointing towards a light source, as you can see here, but some smartphones are definitely better than others, so I had to test this out. I went to the boardwalk at Disney World because there's a ton of rope lighting and bright light sources. This is a great place to test this, and I did notice that it behaved more like the iPhone 15 Pro Max. I was able to spot green orbs being introduced into the photos when they appeared on the iPhone. They were there on the Pixel as well, but for the most part, clean on the Galaxy S24 Ultra. This picture shows this clear, almost mimicking the iPhone in the light reflection pattern, and while they are there on the S24 Ultra, it is nowhere near as noticeable. This isn't a deal breaker because I didn't have it on 95% of the photos that I took at night, so you can see for yourself on the rest of the comparison, but I'll do a Pixel 8 Pro versus Pixel 9 Pro video to see if this is even a problem or not. So let's jump into specific features to dial in on this comparison, and we'll start with the night mode zoom. Here's a shot without night mode, and then here is a shot with night mode, so the pixels didn't change much, but the other two got brighter and crisper. The 5X is next, and here again you can see that blotchy noise pattern on the Pixel. The S24 Ultra and iPhone both have it as well, just nowhere near as pronounced due to the noise reduction. there is the 10x zoom, and you can see the clear difference of what noise reduction is doing for the other two cameras besides the Pixel. What surprised me here though is just how good the iPhone's 25x zoom did. I honestly can't believe it. The Pixel coming in second here, and of course the 100x zoom on the Samsung if you need it. One more back at the boardwalk, this is where I saw those green orbs for the first time. Besides those, I'm really liking the iPhone best here in overall bounce and color replication and noise control. Here is the 5x, and you can see what the more aggressive noise reduction is doing for the roof detail on the Samsung and Apple cameras, while the Pixel lets more noise in to keep detail and to keep things sharper. The 10x zoom looks much better than I ever thought it would from all of them, but the iPhone surprisingly doing the best with the best mixture of keeping the noise down and keeping detail. There is the maximum zoom from Apple, and it keeps it the most color accurate. It is amazing how all of these cameras capture different colors, and the insane 100x zoom on the S24 Ultra just because it can. The 5x optical zoom is probably what people will be using the most, so here's a great example. All did very well, but again, the Pixel is the most noisy here, but very sharp on the details. The iPhone really great with the variations of color here, and it would have definitely been my favorite if it would have handled the lights like the S24 Ultra did here. The Pixel 9 Pro has a very practical feature called Zoom Enhance if you want to squeeze a little more detail out of your zoom shots. It is in the Magic Editor, and while it didn't do too much for this picture, check out what it did to the zoom shot that I showed you earlier. If you zoom in, you can see how AI was able to clean this up to make it more usable, so I really like this feature. If you don't like the more noisy background, you can just cut it out and make it anything you want by typing in a prompt with Reimagined. And now I have a water tower in space. This is so much fun, and I wish more practically though this could be used for the noise reduction algorithm. That makes sense. So what if you don't want to zoom and just want to use high resolution capture instead? Well, let's test that. 48 megapixels on the iPhone 15 Pro Max, 50 megapixels on the Pixel 9 Pro XL, and 50 megapixel and 200 megapixel modes on the S24 Ultra. As you can see again, the Pixel 9 Pro with the brightest picture, so I think you'll notice that in most photos. They all do amazing with picking up a lot of detail, so I don't think you'll be disappointed, but I think the Pixel has the most pleasing processing without over sharpening. You know I had to test the 200 megapixel mode too on the Galaxy S24 Ultra and how it compares. Let's jump into that crazy 1000% scale. And the S24 Ultra is indeed more detailed looking at the bolts, but dang, the iPhone at a quarter of the resolution. Wow, that is very surprising to me. I normally do not use high resolution capture at night, but this is a way to grab a lot more detail in mixed low lighting. The Galaxy S24 Ultra's 50 megapixel mode is also really good here in this scenario, so let me know if you use high res capture at night on your smartphone. Next, let's jump into portrait mode and human subjects. They all look great when they hit, but remember the Pixel 9 Pro XL still has that crazy 1.5x crop, which I hope they change in the next Pixel. It doesn't make sense why this is still here. In this picture of my wife, I really like the Pixel 9 Pro XL here. It has the best balance of sharpness and love that extra bit of vibrancy. The iPhone did the second best with the most accurate capture, and the S24 Ultra looks good as well, but it is the most over sharpened. In this one, I know a lot of people like the more saturated S24 Ultra, but it is the most inaccurate and over sharpened photo out of the three. In this one, I like the S24 Ultra's color rendition the most, the Pixel's too red and arguably the most unpleasant out of the three, and the iPhone pulling in too much yellow as we are used to. They all have different white bounds when it comes to portrait mode affecting skin tones, so let me know which one that you think looks best here. The Pixel has a max 3x portrait mode by zooming in, as you can see here. But in terms of 5x portrait photos, the Galaxy S24 Ultra is by far the best with this larger sensor, so keep that in mind. Just like I saw with the daytime photos, Google's portrait algorithm needs some work. You can see the other two cameras getting this right, where the Pixel 9 Pro's edges are weaker around the top. They all missed the cutout at the top, which is pretty hard, so I understand. But look at this, noticeably worse, so I hope Google improves this with future software updates. Now, where I do think the Pixel 9 Pro XL has the clear advantage is the front-facing camera. Look at just how wide it is compared to the other two cameras. It's refreshing. In terms of clarity and skin tone, I think it's one of the best front-facing cameras available on a smartphone. Sometimes the Galaxy S24 Ultra comes close to matching the tone, but it's still not there. I know the front-facing camera photos are definitely personal preference based, but in almost all of the pictures, I chose the Google Pixel 9 Pro XL. I think it does an amazing job of balancing the entire scene like you see here. The Samsung is too cool, while the iPhone is the most accurate, but it's not as pleasing. The Samsung comes very close here with this portrait mode picture, and it is the sharpest for sure, but I again prefer the Pixel. I do respect the iPhone here for getting the white balance right, but let me know if you agree with me on the Pixel 9 Pro XL's front-facing camera.
It's damn good.
Couple of more random ones before we jump into video. Of course, if you're trying to get moon pictures, AI assisted or not, the S24 Ultra is the absolute easiest and fastest, but I don't think that should sway a buying decision. Here is astrophotography mode on the Pixel, and it ran for over 4 minutes, the Samsung for 30 seconds, and the iPhone for only 8 seconds. And for 8 seconds, the iPhone did extremely well. I was really surprised. Even when you crop in, you can definitely see extra data that the Pixel 9 Pro XL did pick up, but dang, the other two did quite well. I know most people don't use macro mode in mixed lower lighting conditions, but I had to take one just for fun, so let me know which one that you like better. And I know a lot of you asked me, hey, take some pictures inside of your kids when they're not still, and I did exactly this for you just to test out the shutter speed. They all do pretty well keeping the faces sharp while there is motion blurring on the arms, but I did catch the iPhone with better shutter speed a lot of the time, and you can see that when you're watching. They all have their moments and fails, but if I had to call a loser, it would probably be the Galaxy S24 Ultra, and to be honest, they all did better than I thought they would, so that is a good thing. But out of the big three, I think the Pixel and the iPhone have the best performance, and I think there's only one phone that I know of that can beat these, and that is the Huawei Pura 70 Ultra, so let me know if you want to see that comparison, and I'll make it happen. One feature that I was super excited about using was AddMe, where you can superimpose yourself into a group selfie, and it did kind of work here even though I was a little too far back and that was our mistake, but you get the point. If you want to see it in more detail, check out my daytime comparison because it really works well there in good lighting, but I was having more difficulty using this feature at night where it would give me more errors, so just keep that in mind. I'm sure this feature will get better and more optimized as time goes on, so I'm hoping this gets better for nighttime capture. Okay, so let's jump into video. This year, the Pixel 9 Pro lineup gets 8K video, but with the twist, it is shot in 4K and then boosted in the cloud to turn it into 8K video. Samsung has had true 8K video for a long time now, and the iPhone 15 Pro Max is 4K, and these are all shot at 30 frames per second. And the Pixel 9 Pro's video looks really good in this scenario. It is definitely the sharpest, and the noise is cleaned up nicely in the sky compared to the Galaxy S24 Ultra sky. It is noticeably worse, and the iPhone is solid as usual in the video department with a more accurate rendition of the scene. Here is more 8K video, and the iPhone 15 Pro Max is still undefeated in video when the green orbs aren't getting in the way. Look at how much better the noise control is on this one. It's so drastic compared to the others. And the Pixel again is sharper, but the sky is mishandled, so some tuning is definitely needed. Samsung is noisy again, so I hope they continue to work on this. To make things fair, I put them all at 4K 30 frames per second. I think 8K isn't worth it at night for the S24 Ultra because 4K looks better most of the time. But this is the Pixel 9 Pro XL's night mode video boost and looks solid, so I'm impressed with the nighttime video, so let me know what you think in the comment section below. When looking back at all this nighttime video, I think Google has something here because it does look very detailed and also the clarity is noticeable. So once Google figures out how to do this on device outside of the cloud infrastructure, this could be more practical. I took this minute long clip and I think it took about 6 or 7 hours to process, so that is still pretty long, but you get the original version right away to use and you get to keep both in your photo library, so it's not hindering unless you want to share that boosted version right away. The only downsides I see in the current iteration is that on 4K you can get over sharpened video where it looks too processed, but in this 8K version, look at all the artifacting that you get in the sky here, so Video Boost does have some optimizations to go through, but once they get this perfect, it could mean huge things for nighttime video clarity for the Pixel lineup moving forward. Another example where you can see what the video boosting is doing is in the stabilization while you're walking. It's almost like using a stabilizer in editing software. You can see it when I turn, it has those characteristics. In boosting, it helps with the clarity, the detail, and the brightness, but also stabilizes the footage. And when I get onto a straight path again, you can see a huge difference in clarity and sharpness on the Pixel 9 Pro XL. It is very impressive. So again, Google is onto something here. The iPhone 15 Pro Max does have better stabilization at night in this scenario. It is for the most part smooth, where you can see micro jitters and software enhancements on the Pixel's footage if you look closely. And you can see my bounce from my walk a little more on the S24 Ultra with as much noisier video again. So for consistency, I still think the iPhone 15 Pro Max all around is better for nighttime video, and it still has the smoothest lens changes. So I'll show you a full range video zoom test while we conclude. As we zoom in farther with the Pixel 9 Pro XL,
tell, I did notice a little more of my handshake coming through on the video, but I'm going to say I'm more impressed with the nighttime video with the boost enhancements that Google is doing. The daytime did not translate this well, and I was a little disappointed there, but keep going with this, Google, and I hope to see this done on device in the near future. So to wrap things up, I think if you're waiting for Google to come out and absolutely destroy Samsung and Apple at launch, I don't think that happened at all. The Pixel 9 Pro series is definitely solid, but I can't say photography-wise is significantly better. I think if you like the brighter photo at night, you'll enjoy the Pixel 9 Pro XL, but let's see where Google takes this camera with some software updates. My surprise, though, is how well the iPhone 15 Pro Max held up at night despite being the oldest here, and the S24 Ultra is always a solid choice when it comes to being one of the most flexible camera systems out there. So I'm not going to make my decision quite yet. I'm going to revisit this and replace the iPhone with the iPhone 16 Pro Max and let Google and Samsung push out a few more software updates, and then we can decide who is the king of night photography and video. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you enjoyed this. If you did, then hit that thumbs up button. Subscribe for a lot more videos and comparisons just like this one, and I will see you in the next video.